chapter 15 from 101 Secrets of Effective Parenting. Are your children like Gandhi? This is one of the real-time experience what I had, where there was a mom and dad who came up to me with a son who is 14 years old, to came up to say, see our son this way because he acts like Gandhi, right? And he accepts everything. He's so passive. People can take him for granted. His friends always, takes him for granted. And he's okay with all those things. And as a parent, one of the biggest worry what we have is just as he grows up, as he becomes bigger, if he's going to be like this in life, so it's going to be difficult, right? In a workplace, he'll be taken for granted. So in his life, he'll be taken for granted. So he'll be going through a lot of pain. So as mom, as a dad, we are really worried about his future. This is something what the father shared, and he started giving a lot of examples, because even now, if you go ahead, check, if he finishes all the homework, he will even stay back in school to show his homework to other children so that they can copy down, and he lands up doing the work of all other people, and he has no regret, or he has never expressed any unhappiness for all these things. So he is almost like Gandhi, right? First thing what came to my mind was the analogy is completely wrong, because Gandhi is not a person who will accept everything. He is somebody who is so assertive. He has the courage to send people out, and that's what Gandhi is. So the analogy itself is completely not right. So I wanted to make the parent understand, or I want to go deeper into it. So just to look back what has happened in the life, the father had more things to share, because when I was actually ill sometime back, I was terribly ill, and my son was just 12 years old that time, who was staying with me, who used to assist me a lot, who used to do a lot of things for me, which I don't think any other children of his age will possibly do this, right? And all those things make me think, is he fit for life? Is he getting ready to face the life? So that is always a big concern. He will get affected, even small things. When I feel hurt, when I feel low, he himself will get affected. So that's something what we go through. And I know it is very, very different from rest of the parents, because there are days we want him to catch up with some fight in school, have some misbehavior happening inside the school where we get some complaint, but it never happens, because as a parent, we are really looking forward for those kind of things where somebody complains about him, teacher unhappy with him. It's all completely different. All his friends are so happy. He always responds to them. He always goes with whatever they say. The teacher always says he's completely obedient. So it's good in school, but I'm not sure whether it's good in life. So this is a serious concern what the parent had. So I need to go ahead to make them understand, or make them find out. So ask them questions. Last, when you have actually scolded your child? Oh, then the father said, never. We never scold the child. And are there instances when you felt really very unhappy with him? Yeah, there are instances. Even recently, we got something very wonderful when we went abroad. We kept it at home. He just mishandled it, and then he broke that nice flower vase kind of stuff, and we were very, very unhappy. So what he did, we never scolded him, because my son is more precious than all these sort of things. So I said, it's fine, you forget it. But whether you felt unhappy, I felt terribly bad, because we really liked it. We got it. That's what the father told. So there lies the answer. Because when you terribly feel bad about something, you have not expressed yourself. You have not told, this is what I want. This is not the way you can possibly do it. Because where the children learn is what you actually go through, what you actually do it. That's where you have not displayed assertiveness. You have not showing assertiveness to your own child. So when you don't scold, that will not make you as a better parent, but you teach them how to accept everything in life. You have to be assertive. You need to express how you really feel. Remember, effective parenting is not always about being nice to your children. It is about being assertive and standing up for your own rights as a parent. Just go back and check. the kind of things what you do, are you displaying assertiveness? Because assertiveness is not taught, it is something what is learned. To share the secret, secret number 15. If you stand up for your rights, then your children will not have to be taught this quality. Remember, parents, the best way to teach is through example.